Coming up on this episode of New England Hockey Journal, we visit Sacred Heart University. The Pioneers are building for the future, and we'll take a look at the men's hockey team and what's next for this Division I program.
Come on, get up. Get up, get up, get up, get up, get up! That's it, that's it. Faster, boys, faster, faster, faster!
It's a January practice on the road before a game at Bentley University. This scene was a familiar one for the Sacred Heart men's hockey program. In the 2021-22 season, the Pioneers played 26 road games and only 9 at home.
We haven't complained about it once. Our guys have been great. It's hard for us in terms of we don't get to practice at the same place every day. We're carrying our bags over to a rink, bringing our bags back, bags in the car, taking bags home. Hit that net, boys, hit that net.
COVID last year definitely was weird. You know, every weekend, day of the game, day before the game, it's like, who knows if we're even playing. Everybody on the team had to go through their own sort of periods where they were quarantining, you know, miss games, sit out of practice. Then this year, just with the rink situation, feels like we've been living on the road. And it was difficult, but I think, you know, there's a way to sort of take a positive out of it.
With this year, we had a team where there was a lot of new guys, so I think that time on the road allowed us to get close with one another and kind of form some bonds.
That's Gehring, he buries it.
If you take it for what it is, I think it allowed us to get really close as a team, and I think we did all right with the circumstances.
Their home ice is at the Webster Bank Arena in Bridgeport, Connecticut. Due to the pandemic, the arena, which is home to several collegiate and professional teams, ran into scheduling conflicts as they looked to make up for business lost the season before. The only way Sacred Heart could adjust to the scheduling conflicts was to play most of their games on the road. This all changes next January when the brand new Martiri Family Arena opens its doors.
And every time I drive by coming to class here, it's just so exciting. You know, have a rink of your own and be able to call a place home. It's going to be great.
Sacred Heart plays in the Division I Atlantic Hockey Association.
Centering pass, stop, score!
It's great hockey. What I've noticed in my time here is like the parity in the conference. Like anybody can beat anybody any given night, really. So it's really competitive and every game matters.
The feed out front, shot, goal!
That's definitely, I think, a conference on the rise and under-respected right now.
I think there's great coaching in our league. I think the coaches have done a terrific job of recruiting better players, better student athletes. We're getting new facilities in our league. I mean, Bentley has a new facility. AIC has gone from a local rink like us to the Springfield Civic Center. The schools are getting behind the programs and giving the coaches some more bullets to play with.
Reno will shoot, snipe, and score.
Every year, the Pioneers schedule some early season games against top programs in the East. Of course, this season they were all away games.
We want to test our team against the best teams in the country. I mean, we've done that this year, and I think it just prepares us for once we get into our league. And it gives us a measuring stick of, hey, we can compete with these guys, we could beat these guys. And at the end of the day, that's how you build a winning culture.
Down the road, those matchups can only help you as a team. Obviously, you want to be challenged. You kind of see what it's going to take against those top teams, and you learn from it, and you try to take things from those games and carry them on down the road.
Centers one and a goal.
Over the last two decades, hockey has grown in the state of Connecticut. In 2020, Sportsnet New York started Connecticut Ice, an annual tournament featuring the Big Four hockey schools of UConn, Yale, Quinnipiac, and Sacred Heart. It was the Pioneers who took home the bragging rights that first year, beating nationally ranked Quinnipiac.
And the Sacred Heart community came out in droves. Faculty, staff, the student body was terrific. So I think that event gave us a glimpse of how our community will get behind us when we get in a much more intimate atmosphere. In our new facility, the sight lines are going to be terrific. The amenities are going to be second to none. We're looking forward to a great home ice advantage when that arena opens up.
Up next, we'll get up close with head coach C.J. Maritolo. Stay with us.
All right, move our feet and get up in them, all right? Situational play, know the lines, all right? Win the offensive blue line and the defensive line, all right? We know what this game needs to look like tonight from a competitive level. We need to be physical on pucks, hard on pucks all night long. All right, we worked on all week getting pucks to the net, bodies to the net. We need that tonight, and we got to defend our house tonight. All night, all in. Let's go tonight. Come on, let's go.
In his 13th season, Sacred Heart Hockey head coach C.J. Maritolo has his program headed in the right direction.
Change in the ozone here. Don't let him, right up. You draw it up.
Maritolo was born and raised in North Haven, Connecticut.
I grew up playing at the Yale Whale, Ingalls Rink. My father was the president of that organization, so I had a key, and I would get in early, 4 o'clock in the morning. I would skate around. My father would go out and get coffee for all the coaches. And then later that night, I would come back and watch the Yale game.
Growing up, he learned a lot about hockey from legendary Yale coach Tim Taylor. He would later become an assistant under Taylor. He left Yale in 2009 to take over the program at Sacred Heart.
Make sure we're on the same page and communicate, all right? And we're going glass on D-zone breakouts. I'm a coach that will push them to get out of their comfort zone to be not only the best player they can be, but best person they can be. I try to coach every kid like they're my son. Sometimes it's going to be hard love. Sometimes it's going to be soft love. I think I have to coach everybody differently to get the most out of them. And to do that, I have to get to know my players. Okay, be careful of running at people like that, straight on. It's too easy of a call, too easy. The ref doesn't even have to like, you know what I mean?
He really pushes you on the ice. He wants to get the most out of you, just like any coach does, but he just has a unique way of getting through to players and making them play their best.
Get to the middle. Good. Skate. Come on, get that deep. Come on. What happened there? Hey, what did it hit? Hey, Gatesy, we need this clean.
You go to a game, you can probably hear CJ yelling wherever you are, but he's hard on us, but that's good. That's what you want out of a coach, right? So he's high energy, loves the game, wants what's best for us as people and as players. Playing for him is awesome.
Gotta be above it. Skate! What I do to one player might not work for another player. I try to create a great relationship, player to coach to player, so where they feel really comfortable coming to me about not only hockey, but life matters, because I don't think you get the most out of players until they know that you really care about them as people, and that's what I try to do.
Moving our feet,
rip puck.
He's a big time coach, you know. Nothing bad I could ever say about the guy, you know. He took a chance on a young guy in Suwanee, Georgia, bring me in here. So, I mean, it's obviously an honor to, you know, play for CJ.
Hey, Josh, they can't get inside our hands. They can't do it. Gotta hit the net, D, hit the net. We worked on it. That's it, make them go 200. Forwards, let's make sure we're talking in the D zone here. A lot of talk, sorting stuff out. Get below it. Go, beat him. Let's go here, boy. Hard on the puck all night long here. Bearing down. Hey, Joyce! Joyce, come on, baby.
We've had a good relationship since day one. You know, he would do anything for us, and it really helps, you know, us try to push for him and play for him. And he brings the energy every day and holds us accountable to do the same.
I like them when they leave here to understand that life isn't easy. You're going to have your ups and downs, just like you do with any hockey season. And you have to have strong convictions in what you do and believe in what you do and believe in your family and your friends, and you'll be able to get through anything. And you can't blame anybody. You have to own things for yourself. I think that's what the game of hockey teaches our guys, and that's what we try to constantly reinforce, that sport mirrors life. And if you put your mind to it, you're going to find success.
When we come back, we'll take a look at some of the players that are making a difference for the Pioneers.
Sacred Heart's having trouble getting the puck out of their zone now. Braden Tuck will saucer one ahead. Great touch on it to Sheahan, shooting, he scores! What a pass from Tuck, and Shea goes glove side, top shelf to tie it.
A great first period goal from Sacred Heart's high scoring duo of Braden Tuck and Neil Shea. In this game against Army, they did it again a little later with almost an exact replica of the first goal.
Shoots and scores! Tuck sprint sauce again! Hit him with the same pass they scored the first goal on. Shea, bar down, top shelf with another snipe. 2-1, Sacred Heart.
Co-captain Tuck is from Calgary, but came east to play college hockey.
I was uncommitted as a 20-year-old my last year of juniors. When I was going through that process, I kind of had a good start to the year that year and sort of was getting a little bit of college attention. And the biggest thing that I had to rely on was just relationships, and you know, I built a good relationship with Coach Scott McDougall and Coach CJ Maritolo, and I saw that Sacred Heart was a program on the rise, and you know, I felt like I was going to be a piece of the puzzle here, and so I think that was the biggest thing in my decision to come to Sacred Heart.
Braden, he's a consummate team guy, 200-foot player on the ice. He plays in all situations, up a goal, down a goal. You know, he's out there on the power play, on the PK. He's just so reliable.
He's a great leader for us. He's an even better player for us. So I've been lucky enough to play on a line with Braden all year, get pretty close to him. He sees the ice really well. He can make plays. He's a really smart player, and he's always giving 110%. He's even keel, and I think that's what you want out of a captain.
Braden is a great captain. He's a little bit of a quiet guy, but he just leads by example. He's always doing the right things. He's just great.
It's been an honor for me to be able to coach him. He's brought out a lot of really good things in me, too. I go to him a lot in terms of how the team is doing. He's got a great pulse of the team, and you know, I seek his advice on a lot of things. So.
Attaboy, dude. Good stick, you pal. Step. One, probably.
Get up!
Jules. Whoa. No way, bro.
You know, we got a good group, and it's not on one guy to just make sure everything's going right. But I do try to, you know, speak up when it's necessary, just try to make, you know, control what I can control and make sure I'm trying to do the right things.
Shoot it, man. Shoot it. He's a big part of our culture. He's a big part of this team, and I'm happy he's wearing red and white for Sacred Heart.
In his first season at Sacred Heart, Shea, a transfer from Northeastern, was among the top scorers in the Atlantic Conference.
Northeastern, you know, some things don't work out. It's not the right fit, and I just kind of thought for me it'd be best to get a change of scenery, and I think it's been a good change for me. Things have worked out here a lot better.
Take a step here, I think, is you know, was huge for him, and it's helped our team a lot. You know, he's a huge part of our team, and you know, it was an adjustment, and to see him sort of get comfortable and being confident, it's great to see.
I think coming from a school where I was kind of in the city, kind of nice to be at Sacred Heart now, where it's a small campus, kind of on its own, and everyone's pretty close to one another.
He's really popped this year as a player. He's our leading scorer, great skater, does everything well. He's starting to develop into a leader right now and how he carries himself. I see him interact with his peers, how he speaks with confidence. I think the sky's the limit for him.
Shea was recently named to the All-Atlantic second team, as was defenseman Logan Britt. And like Shea, Britt also came to Sacred Heart through the transfer portal after playing 2 years with Connecticut rival Quinnipiac. Fellow defenseman Patrick Dawson is from Medway, Mass, and after 3 seasons with the Pioneers, has become a leader on the team.
Patrick Dawson, to me, he's the heart and soul of our team. He plays physical, doesn't give an inch out there to anybody, but the nicest kid off the ice. Polite, always has a smile on his face. He's someone that we really look to as being the standard of being hard to play against. That's Patrick Dawson.
He sort of started his freshman year. I don't think he was in the lineup right off the bat, and just kept working hard and, you know, kind of got his chance. So I really respect him for that, just having a good attitude and sort of taking advantage of his opportunity. And, you know, now he's a huge part of our decor and a leader on the team.
I think I just hold guys accountable on and off the ice, just trying to lead by example too, you know, speak up when it's needed, but again, just let your play talk for yourself.
Tuck, Shea, Britt, and Dawson will all be returning next year to play in the new Metairie Family Center.
Good shot, Tuck.
When we return on New England Hockey Journal, we'll have a look at the new hockey facility.
This university is great. The campus has expanded even since I've been here. It's growing. In general, this whole university is trending in the right direction.
I've only been here 3.5 years, but just in that short span, 5 new residence halls have gone up catty corner to my office. You know, and when parents come on site, you know, they're just blown away by not only the quantity of work being done, but the quality of work being done.
You can feel the energy on campus. Soon, the Martiri Family Arena will officially be the home for both Sacred Hearts men's and women's hockey teams.
It's going to be a great day, not only for Sacred Heart Hockey, but for the entire university and our community when those doors open and we're going to have a facility like we're going to have.
For fans, there's club area. The concourse will have, you know, all sorts of food options and beverage options, and it's a very intimate building.
We'll have suites for the alumni to come back. And it'll be an interactive hallway as you enter the rink, as you park, with things that you'll be able to touch for young kids, things where young kids are going to be able to take pictures. So I think it's going to be a really engaging facility.
Going to bring, you know, top players in. It's going to lift the program up. It's going to make Sacred Heart a destination for a lot of people who want to come.
Every day you drive to campus, you see the progress. It's getting closer and closer. It's going to be unbelievable. I think everyone in the room is excited to have that on our hands, and I think it's going to do so much for not only us as student athletes, but for future players here at Sacred Heart. I think it's going to give our coaches a great resources and tools to have for recruiting, and it's going to be one of the best rinks in college hockey.
Last November, the Columbus Blue Jackets' Justin Danforth became the first Sacred Heart alum to play in the NHL, and the new arena is already boosting the team's recruiting process.
Enables you to attract just a better player. You know, in sports, it's an arms race, and having the amenities from a player perspective, I think, gives you a leg up. I mean, if a kid was on the fence about coming to Sacred Heart, and there's a lot of great reasons to come to Sacred Heart and be a hockey player. But now, all of a sudden, you're in the what's likely for a time going to be the nicest college hockey facility in the nation. So from a competitive perspective, it should help us. And hopefully it will enable us to draw not only from the Sacred Heart community, but the outside community. We should be able to compete nationally with this building.
We're super privileged to have it. It shows a lot about the program to you know, invest in us as a team and as a group, and yeah, it's going to be awesome.
And again, it's not just about the hockey, it's not just about athletics. I think it's just an epitome of what's going on this campus on a regular basis. It's just, you know, continued excellence.
The commitment that this school has shown, not only to the student athlete, but the student first, has been incredible. as a hockey coach here. I feel great support from our administration, and I think this school is going to continue to grow. There's great leadership here in the years to come, and I'm happy to be a big part of it.
Here's the dates to remember. Opening night is January 14th, 2023, as the Sacred Heart men's team hosts the Boston College Eagles in a Division I battle. The next night, the women's team will take on the 2022 ECAC regular season champion, Harvard. It should be a memorable weekend for the entire Sacred Heart community.
Really proud of the effort tonight. We had to fight through a lot of adversity in that game, not getting the first goal, killing off some penalties. Power play was great tonight, a lot of sacrifice. Really, really happy for the seniors, all the seniors, but especially the four-year guys. There's a lot of hockey out on that ice. Good job, boys. You know the plan the rest of the night here. We're gonna, I know some of you wanna see your parents or friends, but we gotta get on a bus to head up to Army. So try not to be too long. Real proud of you. Enjoy this one. And we gotta get to the next one tomorrow, boys, all right? We'll shift into that tomorrow. Good job.
All right, guys, played well. Okay, goals, but.
Good win for the seniors. Let's get it done again tomorrow.